That's hot. Yeah.
Much younger than that time as well. And know many of their histories, which we will not ask the City Democratic City Committee. I thank Lesley University for hosting us. And I think one of the great challenges in our election system today is how we convince people in this district, in this election, even though it is a special election.
I asked each candidate how they would propose, if they were elected to the state senator, to the state senate, how they would get to know young people across this district to understand their needs, both in the classroom and after school in each community.
The great promise of Massachusetts and the hope for the future is our young people. Unlocked doors all across this district, and unlocked doors in Charlestown. And I found out in Charlestown, we meet with a grandmother, and I told her, if I do one thing in the state senate, I'll get the drugs out of Charlestown. She cried. She told me that her grandson had died from OxyContin addiction. It's here in Cambridge, it's in Charlestown, it's in Somerville, it's in Albuquerque, right? It's all through the state. And the saddest part of that story is that he was using his girlfriend, who also died, who survived. And after her survival, she's now presently addicted to OxyContin. There's not a single bed for inpatient treatment in Charlestown. That will change if I'm elected immediately. What I will do is I will go where kids are. And I will make certain that programs like ROCA in Chelsea have outreach workers all through this district in this state to get to kids, early intervention, get them away from criminal justice, get them in full day kindergarten, get them in after school programs, and change their lives before they're lost, so the future promise and hope of this state becomes a reality.
I'm invested in our public school system. My two oldest children go to the Chelsea Public Schools, third grade and kindergarten. I'm a firm believer in early childhood education, 3 and 4 year old early childhood education. That would be a focus of mine in the Massachusetts Center for statewide. I'm in favor of setting our school days to put more sciences and arts back into our curriculum to make our children more well-rounded. I'm in favor of making sure we extend those school days that when I was president of the Chelsea City Council in 1994, that we're building our new school, we make sure we put spaces available. And then in 1997, when they're open, I sponsored a bill that put in there that we made a community schools director. We have community-based after-school programs. I already have a proven record on them. That is the record I'm going to take to the Massachusetts Senate. That is how, for the last 20 years, I've been a youth volunteer and a sports coordinator in the city of Chelsea since 1987. I have already done it. As I always ask people, to see where the person is going, you got to look where they've been. Been there has been a major part of my political stances. Thank you.
In the middle of Bellingham Square in Chelsea the other morning, and waiting to meet with a photographer from the Chelsea Record, and kids were crossing the street and going to school, and about 8 kids came running up, and they were very excited. They recognized me from door knocking in our neighborhood, and they came up to me, and I looked at them, and I saw the promise of the future in these children. And recently, on July 6th, when the budget came out, there were line items for 58 workforce training development programs in the state budget that were coming. So I wrote a letter to Representative DeLayo, the chair of the Ways and Means Committee, asking him for an override, and also to the Senate chair of the Ways and Means Committee. And I think that we need to, I met with him afterwards, and I think that we need to get those resources back to the towns and cities so that kids can have after school programs and they can get into these workforce training programs. So that's what I'll do as a state senator.
I stated in my opening, and I've stated when I kicked off, that I will be a full-time senator. I am currently taking an unpaid leave of absence from my job, and I am not running for re-election to my very comfortable seat that I've been serving for 15 years in Chelsea City Council. I'm asking all of my opponents, all of which, all three, no disrespect, Mr. Attorney General, all lawyers, of course, and one of my opponents is running for re-election to the Cambridge City Council. So I ask my opponents, in being a full-time state senator, will you stop practicing in your law firm, and to the Cambridge City Council, will he withdraw from the Cambridge City Council race if they were fortunate to win?
In Boston, and I've been practicing for the last 6 years down there, and recently, you know, in the last 70 some odd days that we've had since we got into this campaign, I've been working full time, my staff has been working full time on this race. And my practice essentially has been running itself. I've got 3 attorneys that are working there and 2 paralegals, and I will continue to be involved in that practice. But I will spend the majority of my time working as your state senator, and I will be committed to that full time. I've been writing legislation in the time that I'm practicing my, you know, working on my practice, and I've been very engaged in the community affairs and nonprofit organizations across the district, in Cambridge and just about everywhere else. So I will continue to be involved in my practice, but I will be a full-time senator for this district. Thank you.
Question, you've been a very good city councilor in Chelsea. After I announced my candidacy, shortly after, I also announced that I would not hold two jobs. I will fulfill my obligations to the voters who elected me this term, so I will fill out this term. I will not accept a nomination to the city council next term if I'm elected. This is a job that will require my complete attention. You will have it, and you have my pledge tonight that I will not accept a nomination to another term in the city council if you elect me to the state senate, which I'm asking you to do tonight.
My chances, so I haven't made any real business decisions, but I can tell you that when I was at BC Law, I was taught that practicing law isn't a profession, it's who you become, and it's how you live your life. And I've lived my life that way, and I love being a lawyer. And what I love about it is it gives me an opportunity to help people, to help them in their lives. So all of my time, I'm sure, will be consumed by the state senate, and the obligations, the awesome obligations and responsibility of weighing in as one of 40 members of a very thoughtful, deliberative body that has a responsibility in charge of impacting decisions across the state regarding a $28 billion budget. So, if there's any time left over, and I can squeeze in maybe the meeting of the Red Sox game, I'd like to practice law, but if I can't, I won't.
Bye-bye.